Well, the domestic cat is fantastic for rodents. And if they've got enough rodents, they leave your birds, wild birds alone. And we have good experience of that. And Charles Darwin, who wrote The Origin of Species and studied the subject biogeography, he actually documented how red clover was more fertile around villages. And red clover actually germinated better in farmers' fields than it did out in the wilderness. And he couldn't understand why. And he found that bumblebees were the pollinator. Why were bumblebees pollinating more red clover? He looked into bumblebees and he found they were ground nesting bees. They actually lived in a hole. And he thought, did they dig holes? No, they didn't. They occupied the empty holes of other animals, and particularly field mice and rodents. Why would there be vacant field mice holes and rodent holes around villages and around the fields that surrounded the old English villages? Cats. Cats were creating a vacant niche to increase the population by accident of bumblebees, which were pollinating red clover, which was creating nitrogen fixation in the farmers' fields. So, pollination of a plant by connection through to a domestic cat. Now, if you don't like cats, you can always go to other predators like wildlife predators, wilderness predators, owls, and owl nesting boxes, owl perches, predator bird perches. Creating niches for rodent predators with wild animals. That's one of the great ways you can do this.